Volcanic gas from the recent eruptions and activity at Halemaumau continue to be a concern. Jen Boniza finds out where the shifting winds will carry the VOG and what you can do to protect yourself. Jen?
Joe, according to the National Weather Service, the good news is most of the islands are in the clear when it comes to the VOG. The bad news, the Big Island, specifically its leeward coast and South Kona area, could be in the thick of it.
And these are the areas that are of concern, the brighter colors. As you get to the yellows and the oranges and reds, as you can see, much higher near the source itself.
John Bravender from the National Weather Service tells me areas closest to the eruptions and the South Kona area could see thicker layers in the next several days because the wind is shifting.
For the past few days, we have some pretty strong trade winds that have been clearing out the emissions.
He tells me that the change in the direction of the wind and wind speed equals bad news for breathing.
If you're in an area that's upwind of the events, you have to be aware of what's going to be coming in the near future because that can turn and you might find yourself in the heart of the VOG plume.
People continue to ask us what measures can they take or what can they do to try to protect themselves against the VOG. What can they do?
First of all, stay as far away as is possible from the VOG. If you're having a cough, something like this inhaler may help opening the breathing tubes to alleviate the cough.
I'm told that using a mask similar to this or a bandana will not protect you against the toxic gases.
It really does not work.
Okay.
So masks are out. Avoidance of the area is in.
Would an air purifier work?
It would be overwhelmed by the amount of hydrogen sulfide that is being emitted from these vents.
Dr. Brady says if you are wheezing or coughing, you should get as far away from the VOG as possible and seek medical attention. Back to you, Justin.